Hello friends, in today's video lecture of machine drawing we'll focus on forms of threads. Okay, there are many types of threads like V-sharp, width form, square thread, acme thread, buttress thread. Okay, here in this case of what you call threads, specifications are standard and that need to be remembered for your examination point. Okay, now the topic is forms of thread. Forms of threads. Okay, there are many types. We'll see few. Okay, it all depends. V sharp, Whitworth. For example, V sharp. Why we use V sharp? What is the condition to use V sharp? These V sharp threads are used when effective positioning is required. Because in case of V sharp thread, the contact between two threads is much higher. Okay, we'll see how to draw those profiles also. Okay, I'll give you a rough explanation before I'll go to actual drawing. Okay, sharp V thread, for example. Now in this sharp V thread, as the name itself indicate, there are sharp ends at two corners above and below. Okay, which will maintain an angle of 60 degrees, angle of 60 degrees, and this height, the height is 0.87p. Nothing but the pitch value, pitch between two end points. Okay, two crests or two troughs, this is p. So here in case of V-sharp, we need to remember what is the angle need to be maintained. This is important to remember. Height 0.87p and p, pitch, pitch value will be given to you in the question. Okay, similarly square, for example, if it is square thread, square thread, you need to, as its name itself indicate, you need to maintain 90 degrees. Okay, 90 degrees. Similarly, there may be width form thread. If it is a width form thread, you need to maintain, you need to remove that sharp corner with small fillet radius. Okay, how to maintain this, we'll see. Now it will maintain an angle of 55 degrees. Now this is maintaining 90 degrees inclination, 55 degrees, and there is a height of 0.64. all these things you need to remember. 64 p, in between two there is a pitch of p. Okay, and what is the radius? This radius is 0.14p radius, that need to be followed, that is also important. Okay, similarly you have buttress and warm thread also. Okay, we'll see how to draw them one by one. Okay, now what I do is I'll start with sharp V thread. Sharp V thread. Now here, in case of all these threads, we'll try to make hatching. Okay, because threads may be internal or external, those are not visible actually. So for example, there is a hexagonal bolt of this kind which is having a threading. Okay, this type. Now this threading representation, when it got section from top to bottom, when it got section from top to bottom, in such cases you could see that profile, that same profile we are going to draw. Once it got section, we need to hatch. Same thing we are going to perform in here. We need to hatch the model. Okay, that is also important. I'll start with Whitworth V sharp thread. Okay, which will have larger contact area. For example, I'll start with number one, sharp V thread. Okay, now we need to calculate what is height. We need to remember them all. What is height, what is pitch, what is the angle. In case of sharp V thread, the angle maintained is theta is equal to 60 degrees, height is equal to 0.87 p, pitch value will be given to you in the given data. Okay, question mark may be given. How to draw the profiles, that we'll see. Okay, by considering this value, height 0.87 p, initially draw one locus infinite distance at a height of 0.87 p, draw one more locus parallel to the baseline. Okay, 10 mm away start your profile. Now as it is maintaining 60 degrees inclination in between two lines, inclination lines, so initially what we try to do is I'll try to divide, or I'll make a point initially at some offset distance. I'll make a point. Okay, from here I'll draw one locus, small locus with 2H pencil. Again, it is 60 degrees inclination supposed to be, so on either side of the line I'll make it 30 30. This is 30 mm line, this is one more 30 mm line. Okay, again with respect to this line, next line is 60, again one more 60 60 60, this is also 60. Okay, this is how you need to draw with 2H pencil. Once it is done, with the help of a HB pencil, darken the lines, required lines. This is required, this is also required, darken the required lines. There you get the actual profile. Okay, now let the above and below lines remain same with 2H pencil. Now with the help of HB pencil again, try to place dimensions. Okay, draw this curve not with freehand, draw this curve also with help of compass. Okay, this is maintaining 60 degrees inclination, 0.187 p. okay, and a pitch of whatever the value given in the question, this is p. Pitch may be given to you, pitch is equal to maybe some 12 mm, 15 mm, 20 mm, accordingly calculate H value, you will get this profile. Okay, now sharp V, as I said, sharp V used in some effective positioning. Where you require more contact between two surfaces, in the such cases we use sharp V threads. Okay, we can also call, I mean, we can, one more point we can make, we can use it in application like larger contact areas. Okay, this is a small description or two points about sharp V thread. Next, number two is, we'll go with some other, let us take it as square thread. Okay, simple. Now if you consider square thread, again you have few specifications for square thread that need to be remembered. Now the height is equal to 0.5 p height, and width is also is equal to 0.5 p. here theta is equal to 90 degrees. Okay, this need to be followed. Now consider height, which is 0.5 p. draw two locus lines, number one parallelly at a height of 0.5 p, draw one more locus. Okay, now with the help of drafter, try to place vertical lines, number one, and there is a width of 0.5p. from here 0.5, drop the line, 0.5, drop the line to the top, 0.5, drop the line, close it. Okay, this is how we'll represent square thread. Okay, now square thread which is maintaining a height of 0.5p and a width of 0.5p, both are similar, 0.5p, okay, and an angle of 90 degrees. Okay, now fine. Now next, second, third one is, let us consider Whitworth. Whitworth thread. Okay, now for this Whitworth thread also we have some specifications to remember. Height which is 0.64p and small r 0.14p and angle theta is equal to 55 degrees. Okay, and pitch will be given. Now whatever the thread may be, try to consider the height first, which is 0.64p. you can draw two locus lines, number one, number two, okay, with respect to whatever the height you got, 0.64p. okay, after drawing this line, again make a mark somewhere on the horizontal or on the above or bottom horizontal, and consider r value 0.14p on this vertical line. Try to make a mark of 0.14p, calculate the value 0.14p, from this intersection make a mark of 0.14. okay, and with that radius draw the curve, a semicircle, draw a semicircle. Okay, now at some offset distance of p, whatever the given value, again at some offset distance make a mark of p or p by 2. From here maybe this is p, up till here p, again apply the same principle, r value, from here make a mark, draw a semicircle with 2H pencil. Everything till here has to be done with 2H pencil only. Finally when you draw the profile, draw with 2HB pencil. Okay, again at p by 2, if this, the whole distance is p from this end to that end, if this is p, at p by 2 apply same principle again, from here make a mark of r, draw a semicircle. Okay, after drawing all the semicircles, align your drafter tangentially. Okay, in between these two curves, align your drafter tangentially. You are not supposed to meet these two corner points, these two corner points, you are not supposed to meet them. You are supposed to draw a line, it should pass through tangentially. Okay, something like this, from here to this point, from here to this point. Similarly, next one, maybe if here you have a curve, something like this. Okay, this is how it should go. Okay, obviously it will maintain an angle of 55 degrees. Okay, if you could manage this way, it will, if you justify any two dimensions, third will automatically managed. Okay, if you consider these two, this will get managed. If you consider these two, this will get managed. Now we have considered h and r, theta will get managed. If you cross check, that will obviously maintain the same angle. Okay, now try to darken with hp. Okay, this is how you'll get a profile, okay, which is maintaining an angle of 55 degrees and a height of 0.64p. okay, pitch value is given to you and you need to represent r also. R is equal to, this is r. Okay, what is r? that you have already calculated. Okay, you need to make, you need to show all the calculations beside the drawing also. Okay, without these calculations, this is useless. Okay, that is also important. Now similarly, we'll go with the fourth representation of thread. Let us take buttress. Buttress thread. Okay. Now it is a combination of V-sharp and square thread. V-sharp and square thread. If you combine these two, you'll get buttress thread. Combination of V-sharp and square. These two combinations will give you buttress. Okay, it all depends on the application point. It has an ability to transmit power, and it has raw frictional resistance also. Okay, we are not concentrating much on the application point. We'll see how to draw again. We need to remember few specifications here. Again, the height. Height is equal to 0.66p. Okay, and what is angle, which is 45 degrees, and the width we are following here is 0.16p. okay, and there is one more angle. Let us consider this as theta, next one as theta 1. 7 degrees need to be followed. How to justify them all? P value will be given to you in the examination or a question paper. Okay, now what you try to do initially, what is the concept? Take value of h, draw one locus, consider that height. Okay, draw one more locus parallel to the baseline. Now to place your profile in between. How to place it in between? We'll see now. Just drop one vertical initially at some distance. Now what is the height? 0.66p. Drop one vertical. Okay, now consider the thickness w, 0.16p. consider this as 0.16p, and align your drafter to 45 degrees from top to bottom and draw an inclination of 45 degrees, or else better to go in this way, a vertical followed by a thickness 0.16p. now from here to next pitch value, consider pitch value whatever given in the question, drop one more vertical from here. Okay, this is the pitch distance. Okay, once you got the pitch, you can set your profile in between. That is bit easier. Okay, so how to do this? For example, this is not supposed to be vertical. Again, we need to consider 7 degrees also. We forgot in this 7 degrees. Now this should not be exactly vertical. It should maintain an angle of 7 degrees. This should maintain an angle of 7 degrees. Okay, from that 7 degrees means there is one more vertical here. This is the actual vertical line. This is 7 degrees line. In between, there is an inclination of 7 degrees. Okay, this is vertical, this is 7 degree line. From that 7 degree line till the next 7 degree line. Okay, maybe consider this as one more 7 degree line. This is pitch. Okay, now it is 0.16p. from here to back side again, this is also 0.16p. if you have justified 1, 2, if you have justified 1 and 2, you'll get the next one in an automatic way. Join these two endpoints, because this distance is equivalent to this distance. Join these two to get the profile. Okay, again from here 0.16p, again from here at a distance of p, drop a line parallel to this 7 degrees line. Draw one more line, 7 degrees 7 7. Okay, if this is 0.16, this is also 0.16. join both the ends. Okay, in a similar fashion, continue one more profile. Drawing 3 or 4 profiles are enough to represent a thread. Okay. Now this is a required one. Now try to darken the profile, okay, whichever is required. This is 7 degree line, darken, 0.16, 45 degrees inclined, 0.16, 7 degree, 0.16, 45, 0.16, 7 degree line, 0.16, something similarly. We'll get this representation. Okay, now show all the dimensions. For example, this is maintaining an angle of from this vertical to this inclination, it is maintaining 45 degrees inclination, and in between these two there is a distance of, that you need to remember, 0.16 p, okay, and height is already represented. We have drawn only 1, 2, 3, 4 stages. If you draw 3 stages, that is also enough, okay, but try to show most of the dimensions. Similarly, I'll try to place one more vertical from here to here, 45 degrees, okay, no need to place, but to make you understand, I have placed twice. Over dimensioning is also not correct, okay. Now this is how we'll need to represent. We'll go with the fifth representation quickly. Let us consider it as acme thread. In a similar fashion to V-sharp, buttress and all, for acme also there are few dimensions need to be remembered. Height, okay, which is height is equal to 0.5 p, okay, this is half of the height, maybe h by 2 I can call it as, it is not a complete height actually. Theta need to be remembered, 29 degrees, that is also important, and the width 0.37 p, width is also important to remember. Pitch value obviously given in the question, okay. Why I said this as h by 2, that we'll see, okay, why it is h by 2 we'll see. Now I'll try to draw a locus similar to the way we did for buttress. I'll draw one locus. At what height I need to represent height, that is my question mark, because I said it as h by 2, okay. If it is h by 2, I need to calculate now the height. Sorry, this is h, h is equal to 0.5 p, 0.5 p, okay. From here I'll make a mark of 0.5 p, I'll draw one locus, okay. After drawing the locus, try to place the width. I'll consider 0.37 p, I'll try to place the width on the top or bottom horizontal here, from here to here, 0.37 p, okay. Now centrally I'll try to draw, for my understanding I'll try to draw one small hidden line or an axis line for better understanding, okay. After drawing this, again here the angle is given already, it is 29 degrees, so divide the angle into 2, divide by 2, split it into 2 halves, okay, which is 14.5 degrees, 14.5 degrees. If you could maintain with 14.5, from this end point draw 14.5 degree line, considering this as the baseline vertical, from here again 14.5, that is one way of drawing it. The another way is, there is one more width, this width is already represented, is already given, which need to be maintained, 0.5 p again. If this height is equal to central width, if you could manage to do that on a center line, you can draw it, that is also easy, okay. 0.37 p, I'll draw 0.37 p. now I'll implement the other way. What is that? I'll consider 0.5 p, I'll take the midpoint of this line, midpoint of this line, I'll try to mark the midpoint over here. From the midpoint I'll split this 0.5 into 2, 0.5 p divided by 2, then what happens? 0.25. from here I'll make a mark of 0.25, obviously it will come and meet this particular point. So try to draw a straight line passing through this intersection. This is also correct. So if you want, you can calculate or you can draw a inclination line by considering the angle, or else you can consider the height also equivalent to width of threading center. This height is equivalent to width of threading center. If you could manage with that width also, you can draw the sketch. Again, this is 0.37. again, there is an angle of 14.5 degrees. Okay, now try to darken the required portion. This line is important to HB pencil. HB, darkening the required portion is also very much important. Okay, don't bother about the 2H lines, let it be, don't erase them. Okay, now try to specify all the dimensions. Height we know already, and angle is 29 degrees in between. Draw this curve, dimension curve also with compass. Okay, this distance is 0.37 p. okay, pitch value, now you can easily show the pitch value also from this point, this end point, extreme end width I'm taking from here to next end. This distance is p, this is p, that is given already. Okay, and height we have already represented. So you can do in both the ways, by considering the value or else by considering the width also. This width from here to this point, this width is 0.5 p, which is equivalent to the height. Okay, this is about Acme thread. Straight away we will move on to the next one, which is warm thread number 6, warm. Okay, warm thread, fine. Here also we have few specifications to remember. Now this type of thread is used in case of shafts to carry power to worm wheels, maybe. Okay, carry power to the worm wheels, that is the application point. Okay, we'll move on to the drawing. H is equal to, values need to be remembered, 0.69 p, theta is equal to 29 degrees. Okay, now this is a similarity between these two. 29 degrees is similarity, and pitch will be given to you. Width is equal to 0.34 p. here also it is not almost similar, 0.37 p 0.34 p. okay, now p will be given again, given value. Simple, I'll do bit faster this time. What I try to do is, I'll try to draw the baseline by considering the height. I'll draw this baseline by considering the height, which is 0.69 p. I'll draw one more locus above. Okay, after drawing this locus, you have to consider width and the height. Height is already shown. What is the width? Okay, width is 0.34 p. I'll make a mark of 0.34 p. I'll darken it. Divide the angle whatever given in by 2. It's 29 degrees, 14.5. So from here, draw that 14.5 degree line, 1, 2, until it go and meet with the bottom horizontal. Again, 0.34, again do the same concept, apply the same principle, 0.34, same again, 0.34. Now darken with the help of HB pencil. 1, 2, required object or the projection need to be darkened all the time. Okay, and show all the dimensions, the angle which you have maintained, 29 degrees, and the height and width that you have maintained, which is 0.34 p. okay, all these are very much important. Okay, this is about warm thread. Okay, other than this, now as I said initially, It is a cut section. Once you cut the model, you could see all the profiles of this kind. Okay, so if you cut the model, you need to hatch the model. That is also important. Okay, so how to hatch the model? Simply maintaining 45 degrees inclination with an angle of, with an offset distance of 2 mm. Okay, now as I'm drawing with my free hand, what I try to do is I could manage. Now try to consider some offset distance with 2H line. Try to match up all the lines with this particular baseline. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. There is no count actually. For my understanding, I'm doing it. There won't be any count. Okay, you'll get proper alignment. That is the reason we'll take the baseline. Okay, similarly in this case also. 45 degrees inclination with an offset of 2 mm. Okay, I'm drawing it with my free hand. Okay, but when you consider a drafter, you have to draw with your drafter. What you need to do is you need to make points like 2, 4, 6, 8, maybe. Okay, with your drafter, align your drafter to 45 degrees, join with all the lines which you have made marked already. 1, 2, 3, something like this. Okay, this is also important. It should be drawn with 2H pencil. There should be proper uniformity between the lines. There should be proper angle need to be maintained all the time. Okay, if you are not getting properly, try to make markings of offset distance 2 mm 4 mm 6 mm. Okay, 45. As I'm somewhat free with my hand, so I'm trying to maintain that offset properly. Most of you are not used to it, so kindly make markings initially, then go ahead with your drafter maintaining 45 degrees inclination. Fine. Now this is about thread profiles, which is must and should question in your first mid as well as in your external. Try to concentrate more. Most of you can remember all the things, but the only thing is you don't know where to start the question. How to take the height, how to maintain the angle, how to split it into two. Okay, still it is a very big question. For example, from the base, from this particular line, you need to maintain some angle of 14 degrees or 14.5 degrees. How to place your protractor? Protractor has to be placed something like this. So with respect to vertical, you need to calculate. If this is 0, you need to go up to 14 degrees. This is 14 degrees angle. Okay, in some cases you need to consider protractor here also. That is also there. Okay, how to place the protractor, that all you know better, so I no need to explain all the minor things. So this is about forms of threads or types of threads which are used under different working conditions or different application points. We are not focusing much on the applications, and we are focusing more and more on how to draw them with the standard specifications given. Okay, thank you. And if you have any doubt, you can comment, you can subscribe. Thank you.